Get ready to match the stars. Robert Urich. Brett Summers. Gary Burghoff. Jamie Lynn Bauer. Richard Dawson. And Fannie Flagg. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 75. And now here's the star of Match Game 75.
Hello, Johnny Olson. How are you? Thank you, friends.
Nice to see all of you here in person, and those of you who's joined us via the magic of the mega cycles. And you're splendid to show up, too, because without you, where would we be, I ask you?
I don't know. Where would you be, sweetheart?
I'd be nowhere. I'd
be back in the hotel room, honey.
In Encino, in that, that El Cheapo motel.
You told me.
You've made the reservation?
Uh-oh. I'm sorry, I'm not free tonight.
But she's paying.
You mean it's over between us now that Urich is on the show?
Just for a moment.
That's treat, though.
You know me.
Yeah, well, okay, it was just in the nick of time.
If anybody spotted a joke amongst all of that conversation, please write in Richard Dawson here to match.
We're foofing around, though, yeah, hoping. Let's say hello to John Liban and Lily Young there. All right, John. John is our current champ. He's won a total of $600. He's being challenged by Lily Young. She's had her first round question, and we're about to deliver one to you. John, are you ready for it?
I certainly am.
Okay, we'll slip it to you in 1 minute and 4 and 5/6 seconds. Shall we have a go at it? All right. We'll push this button here, reveal the other first round question for John Liban, and ask all of you to listen carefully and participate. The cannibal said...
Yum,
he said,
yum.
No. He said, I just put a missionary in the pot, and you'll never believe what happened. The missionary blanked the water. That's what happened, John. Would you believe that?
It's tough.
The missionary blanked the water. He did that. Okay. Upper tier is ready. Good. Good, good. Okay, here we go with John Liban. The cannibal said, I just put a missionary in the pot and you'll never believe what happened. The missionary blanked the water.
Soiled.
You did not give the popular favorite answer with the audience, I suspect. We'll find out what happens here. Robert, what'd you say?
The missionary drank the water.
Drank the water.
Save himself.
Okay, Brett, what have you got there?
Who is that person booing?
I don't know.
Me.
Yes, nice. How can you boo a guy, a good-looking star of SWAT like that? What?
Yeah.
What do you say, Brett?
I say drink, drunk, drank.
Drank the water, yes. Uh-oh. All right, Gary.
I said, bless the water.
Yes. That's the answer.
Yeah, we sure is.
Bless the water, John? Yes. Now, Jamie, it's up to you. He's looking for the answer, soil the water, whatever that means. And we're not going to explore it any further. It's show and tell time.
Soil. Of course, he blessed the water. Sorry.
Bless the water. So, and Richard, you, sir.
What was the question?
The question was, you'll never believe what happened. The missionary blanked the water. He said soiled. It's there somewhere.
Just had a religious experience. Yeah.
He blessed the water. Yeah. Miss Curvaceous, what do you say?
Now, John, I want to talk to you after the show.
Patsy.
Contaminated.
What? Oh, soiled, yeah.
Oh,
one of them is a narrow Baptist.
Right. Who's on
Did
the buzzer today?
Just turned off.
Deidre is on the buzzer today. You're a little, you have your fingers a little too quick, my dear. Oh, thank you. All right.
See you at the door.
See you at the door. I push the button, go to the second round. Scores 1-0 at the end of the first round in favor of John. Lily, please make your choice.
I'll take B.
B it is. Here we go. When they asked the Miss America contestant to name her best feature, she picked her blank.
Oh, am I going to answer for you?
Yeah, well, don't give it to us. Give it your second choice.
I love my answer.
When they asked Miss America contestant to name her best feature, she picked her blank.
I love my answer.
All right, waiting for...
Hold your hand.
Okay. Put it in the slot there, and away we go. Everybody ready? Lily Young. When they asked the Miss American contestant to name her best feature, she picked her blank.
Her bosom?
Her top. Bosom?
Her top.
Now, Lily, wait, hold on just a minute. She has given us a word halfway between the upper and the lower. She said bosom. You mean bosom?
Bosom, yes.
Bosom, okay. What do you say, Bob?
I thought about all those things.
You didn't.
I did. But I said personality.
Personality.
I don't like handsome guys either.
Yeah. Okay.
I do.
You do. What do you say?
I say Quinella Quickfinger, watch it.
Yeah.
Because I think this is a match and I don't want any arguments.
Not a match?
She, what was the question?
When they asked her to pick her best feature, she picked her blank.
She picked her Fannie Flags.
Her Fannie Flags? Her Fannie Flags.
Her Fannie Flags.
Or her blue
flags. Oh, no.
Yeah, come on. Oh, okay.
She really twisted your blank, didn't she? What do you say, Gare?
Well, I think this is a match. I said her car keys. That's another show.
Yeah.
Another audience.
No reference,
everything.
Nothing, right? Yes.
Geez, it's funny. They laugh, too. Yeah. Right?
What do they know?
I gotta stop giving them those. Never mind. I said boobs.
Okay. You can't say boobs.
Well, I said it.
So?
It's in my contract.
She's looking for the answer, bosom. What do you say?
We don't talk about that in my family.
We don't?
So I put nose.
When they asked her to name her best feature, she picked her nose. Didn't mother ever tell you never to do that? How many times do I have to tell you? Just for that, I'm never going to kiss you again.
Oh, please.
No.
Her sister has two of the cutest noses you've ever seen in your life. I said Bob's.
Yeah. Now, speaking of
again?
Boobs, we call on Fannie.
Well, you have to read the question because she really took it literally.
When they asked the Miss America contestant to name her best feature, she picked her...
Well, see, I made a mistake. When you said feature, I was thinking of film, and I said the first one she made.
Be kind.
Oh. You really are getting weird.
No, that's...
It was real nice. It was called Schoolgirls.
Or Boobs Galore.
So at this moment, the middle round two scores 3-1 in favor of Lily. Your second round question will come up in a little while, but right now this is coming your way. Now, middle of round two score is 3-1 in favor of Lily. John, you've got to match two celebrities to stay in the game, 3-win. Here we go. Bill said, for 2 weeks now, I've been feeding my pet mouse nothing but dog food, and now he started to blank. You don't play this. He met you in the last round, Fannie.
Yes.
You lay out.
Lay out, then.
For 2 weeks, I've been feeding my pet mouse nothing but dog food. Now he started to blank.
Okay.
How are you, Red Eyes?
Red Eyes.
She's extraordinary at some things.
Yes, she is. Quite. Okay. Everybody ready?
Yeah.
All set. Now, John, Bill said for 2 weeks now, I've been feeding my pet mouse nothing but dog food, and now he started to blank.
Bark.
Bark it is. I think they like the answer. What did you say,
That's
Bob?
A terrific answer. It's not my answer, but it's terrific. I said, chase the cat.
That's a cute answer.
Is he cute?
He can do no wrong. Yeah. On with it now, my dear.
I said, good gravy, Marie. I said, bark.
Bark it is. Bark 3-2. Gary?
You can't fool around with animals' diets like that. I said, sit up and beg for X-lax.
Oh. No,
I said, bark.
Bark it is. Nice score. Now, John, one more barking dog, you win the game. What do you say there, Jamie?
I said, woof, woof, bark.
Sir, you stand by for a moment. We'll get to you in a minute. I have to say goodbye to Lily Young. It was a pleasure meeting you, Lily.
I had fun. Thank you very much.
We've got a gift for you. Lily Young is now departing. Okay, John, this is your second time up here. You know how it goes, so we might as well get right to it, huh?
Right here.
Let's not fiddle around.
Not at all.
Okay. Don't fiddle around with me, John. All right. We polled a recent studio audience. Have we got their best response to this? Washington blank. Oh. Earl, you slid that so hard it almost came out the other end. Are you all right, Earl?
Fine.
Okay. You hanging in there?
Right.
Is hot in there?
Awful dark.
It's dark in there, huh? I'll let in a little light, Earl. Are you in there, Earl?
There's Earl. Come here, Earl. Earl, come out here. You thought it was a machine in there. Oh, yeah. Earl, get back in there.
You're very strong tonight, Earl. Bye.
Jean.
Click. Throw away the key. All right. Now, Washington blank. Three of the celebrities are permitted to help. Whom do you call?
I'll try Brett.
How about our nation's capital, Washington, D.C.?
Yeah! Richard?
Washington Monument.
Yeah. Washington Monument? Jamie.
Washington's birthday.
Washington's birthday. That's a legal holiday.
Well, but they took the other two.
So D.C. birthday and monument. You want one of those?
Yeah, I do. I'm going to try Washington, D.C.
D.C. Okay. You try D.C., I'll try A.C., and we'll see how we work out here. Washington, D.C. is what he's looking for. Let's find out if it's up there. May we see the $100 response? Washington Monument is up there, the one that Richard gave you.
Every penny.
Okay. Here we go, looking for Washington, D.C., as we reveal a $250 response. Washington Irving. Remember him? He wrote The Legend of Sleepy Hollow. And last chance for Washington, D.C., here's the $500 response.
Yeah. D.C. it is. Congratulations. Very good.
Now, John, you're up to $1,200. You're going to try now for $5,000. To collect, you've got to match one of them head-to-head exactly. Which one will it be?
I'm going to go with Richard.
Okay. All right. You swing around here and face me, if you would, please, sir. Thank you.
Now, the last time we got together with this...
It didn't work.
You gave me Gable Clark.
Yes, Gable Clark. That's right.
Hey, let's stop at that immediately and win some money.
You have to mention that.
Are you all ready? Well, no, he drew a blank. That happens sometime. Chico blank. That's C-H-I-C-O blank. Chico blank. Okay, he's finished. Now, John, we need an answer from you, one you think will match his. What do you say to that? Chico blank.
Chico and the Man.
Chico and the Man. Okay. He says Chico and the Man will match you for $5,000. Richard, what do you say? You may turn around and face your
most
friend.
Most ridiculous thing I ever heard. Chico and the Man.
What's that little step you do there? Ooh. place. You got your wife or somebody? You got a friend out there?
Yes,
Linda. Oh, there she is. Yeah. Okay. How come, listen, you got $6,200. How come you didn't kiss him? There's always, every time somebody wins $5,000, a lot of kissing going on here.
Well, he told me about that bar he had, and I don't know.
Oh, I see. All right. We'll get back to you in a moment or so, John. We congratulate you. You got $6,200. Right now, we've got this message for you.
It's an amazing how parents course.
Hello there.
Hi.
Let's all welcome Jewel Berg. Shall we do that?
Great.
You know John when I've been here?
Sure do.
Jewel, where are you from?
From Salt Lake City, Utah, Gene.
Yes.
And let me tell you about myself. Well, on second thought, I don't
think I thought I'd say a few words about myself here, Jewel.
Good show. I'll listen.
Well, I'm from the Midwest. I went to college for 20 minutes in Galesburg, Illinois, Harvard of the Midwest, Knox College. And I'm married to a wonderful woman.
That's
and I have
great.
A wonderful daughter named Lynn. Now, you tell me... you stay out of my life. Now, tell me about your life.
Oh, I have a wonderful husband named...
No kidding. What's his name?
Named Bill.
Bill.
And he's a customer service agent and presidential look-alike, self-declared. And we have 6 children, 3 are triplets, and believe it or not, we had 2 more after we had triplets? The triplets.
No kidding.
No kidding.
You weren't fooling around, or maybe you were fooling around.
That's serious business.
All right, Jewel, we welcome you and wish you the best of luck and ask you to make a selection.
B, please.
Here it is. B for Berg, she says. At the secretarial school, Gladys said, this school is really strict. At lunch, they serve us alphabet soup, but before they let us eat it, they make us blanket. Did you all live through that? This school is really strict. At lunch, they serve us alphabet soup, but before they let us eat it, they make us blanket. Alphabet soup, you see.
Alphabet soup.
A strict school. Secretarial school. Secretarial school, very strict. Catherine Gibbs are one of those places
like that,
you know.
It,
you got the animal, then write something.
Oh, okay.
Okay.
Oh, wait a week.
How about a month?
Good.
Isn't that sweet?
And I mean it.
Yes. All right.
Are we all waiting for me?
We're all waiting for you.
Oh, criminy Dutch. Okay, I got it.
Criminy Dutch.
Holy mackerel.
Now, Jewel, at the secretarial school, Gladys said, this school is really strict. At lunch, they serve us alphabet soup, but before they let us eat it, they make us blanket.
Type it.
Type it.
No.
And as the sun sets on Jewel Berg, what do you say, Bob?
I'm tired of being booed.
I don't boo him. If he gives
be
a rotten
nice.
Answer, just give him a nice, polite round of applause, no matter how rotten his answer
they
is.
They go like this.
No, stop that.
Secretarial school, they make them proofread it. Thank you. Thank you.
What are you saying?
I said, and I think this is the best one so far, although it does not a match, and that is the point of the game, so I hear. Or at least that's what Ira was telling me earlier. I said they have to put it in alphabetical order.
That's very good. That's the best answer.
That's not secretarial school.
That's clerical school. You have to put it in
You are a hair splitter.
I did all of those. Really?
Yes.
Showing?
Yes.
No, you have to keep your answers short and simple. Like type.
Type. That's a match.
Certainly is.
Okay. All right, that's one for you, Jewel. Now we come to Jamie. What do you say?
I said alphabetize.
Alphabetize.
Sorry about that.
Alphabetize is the popular favorite with the group here. Oh, I'm sorry. I keep sitting on the place for you.
Yes,
yes.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. All right.
Any messages?
No.
No. I said the same as Brett, but I did not need 2 cards. Put it in order.
Put it in order. All right. Now, you want to hear the question again? This school is really strict. At lunch, they serve us alphabet soup, but before they let us eat it, they make us blanket. And
I said, put it in order.
I said, type it.
What do you say? It's up to Fannie.
Put it in alphabet.
What'd you recharge a battery?
You didn't even get to say your answer.
Holy mackerel.
You know, since we had King Kong work the buzzer, it's never been the same.
All right. Let's Fanny go to a commercial before we all break our ears. Oh, here we are, and that's it. Goodbye. G. Bauer and the Match Game Center. Bye. Join us next time.
Bill Todman production. This program was edited for broadcast.